even as we've temporarily moved online, we can still continue to worship God. Here's how we can have a great virtual worship service at home. Together, we will continue to lift our voices to God. So don't just listen and watch, come and sing with us. Listen, take down notes, and avoid distractions. Receive in faith the word of God spoken to us through the preaching. Let's trust and honor God even in these challenging times, for it is Him who gives us the ability to produce wealth and enables us to excel in the grace of giving. Send us your prayer request and stay connected with the church community. Connect with your victory groups and encourage one another. Together, let's honor God and make disciples online.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Victory Malate.
Welcome to our online service. Sa mga tao sa nasa online, and also for those people who are here on site.
Yes.
We want to welcome you to our 2:30 p.m. service.
2:30, bro.
Grabe, 2:30. Sobrang aga kasi natin, Pastor Israel. But anyway, Pastor Israel, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Yes, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Bro, ano bang ginawa mo nung Christmas? By the way, tanungin na rin natin yung mga kasama natin sa online service
yes,
ngayon.
Uh-oh.
Ano ba yung ginawa nila? How did they celebrate this? Christmas?
We want to know, how did you celebrate this holidays? We want to know, kasi alam natin, just to encourage everyone, no? Kasi ang daming nangyari, and we want to have a celebratory atmosphere here. So we want to know, please comment your kind of celebration this season so that other people would be encouraged and they'll have an idea on how to celebrate this season, Pastor Israel.
Yes. Ikaw ba, bro, paano mo sinelebrate yung Christmas?
Ayun nga. Siyempre, there's a lot of eating, meron ding games, and there's also prayer that happened. So, it was really fun. Sabi ko nga eh, kanina dadulas ako, may pustahan. Wala pong pustahan na nangyari. But of course, kasama kasi sa mga games yung mga prizes online, di ba? So, Gcash is ano?
Gcash
na yung mga prizes, di ba?
Wala na ngayon ano, yung mga physical gifts, no?
Gcash
online
na
pati mga gifts, no?
Yan. Eh, ikaw, Pastor Israel, how did you celebrate?
Sa bahay lang ako nag-celebrate.
Okay.
No, last year. But it's great to spend time with my family,
of course. Come on.
Of course, yung ano, something that I am grateful for. By the way, sa mga ano rin, sa mga kasama namin online, we want to hear from you also. Ano ba yung pinapasalamatan sa Panginoon even in the midst of this pandemic?
Yes. So, what are you grateful for, Pastor Israel?
Oh, na-mention ko kanina umaga, bro.
Yan,
this year, for the past 2 years, nag-celebrate kami ng Christmas at doon lang kami. By next year, bro, apat na kami.
Whoa! Apat na kayo next year!
Yes.
Grabe,
kasama yung yaya.
Bakit? Bakit, Pastor Israel? Kasi?
Because of God's gift.
Yeah, there's gift gonna be another baby on the way for Pastor Israel. Congratulations, Pastor I.
And yes, thank you.
Your wife, Julia. And kayo, anong mga sinaselebrate nyo? And even dito, are you happy that you are celebrating this year? Mga tao dito on site?
We all have something to be grateful for. Kahit na may pinagdaraanan tayong pandemic.
Correct. Yan. Okay. Yan. And because of that, di ba? Yung grace ni God, ano yan eh, it's ever working, di ba? You demonstrate it. And just this past few weeks, actually this month, we've gathered, you know, Noche Buena packages from the congregation and from the people. And we've distributed it. Pastor Israel, naka 1,000 tayo, 1,000 baskets.
Grabe, yan yung ating Love the City campaign.
Yes.
And we would like to thank everyone na nagbigay po.
Yan.
Laking bagay po yan sa mga tao po na naka-receive nung ating mga Noche Buena package.
Thank you so much for your love, the city.
Yun. And of course, yun nga, yung spirit behind that, Yobik, no? That even in the midst of this pandemic, no, we can all be used by God to be a channel of His blessing. So, yung mga iba na talagang naghahanap lang na ayuda tayo, nagbibigay tayo ng ayuda. We want to bless people with physical, not only with the physical gifts, no? Ano ba yung experience mo, Yobik?
Pastor Israel, because of those gifts, doors are open and we're able to spread and share the gospel to people. We've prayed for the Manila Police District officers, mm-hmm. nagbigay tayo sa kanila yung sa swab testing facilities,
yes.
and mga patients and everything. All of it, it's because of the generosity that God has placed in our hearts. It paved the way for the gospel to be preached. And mga pedicab drivers, mga jeepney drivers, they received the word of God, yes. and they responded in prayer. Sobrang amazing si God.
And actually, ganun talaga yung ano, no, yung how we demonstrate the love of God through our giving. And,
yes.
and actually, meron tayo kung ano yan. Meron po tayong video so that they can, ano, no, they can know kung ano po yung mga nangyari dun sa ating pong Love the City campaign. So, let's watch this video.
Let's watch this video.
Clap offering to the Lord. Alam niyo po, napakabuti ng Panginoon na marami pong tao ang hindi lang nakatanggap ng mga pagkain, kundi nakarinig din po sila ng salita ng ating Panginoon. And before we worship the Lord this afternoon, I would like to request everyone to stand as we prepare our hearts to worship the Lord. And let me read these passages from Psalm 100. It says here, make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into His presence with singing. Know that the Lord, He is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him. Bless His name. Verse 5, for the Lord is good, His steadfast love endures forever, and His faithfulness to all generations. Heavenly Father, we just want to honor You and praise You, Lord, this afternoon. Thank You, Father, for reminding us of Your faithfulness and goodness, Lord, in our lives. Alam po na yung Panginoon that even in the midst of this pandemic, nakita po na yung Panginoon ang inyo pong katapatan. We just ask, Father, that as we worship You, Lord, may Your name, Lord, be glorified, Lord, even in the midst of the challenges that we are facing, Lord. We want to honor You. We want to praise You. We want to lift up Your name, Lord. Alam po namin, Panginoon, na habang tinataas po namin kayo sa buhay po namin, kayo po yung Diyos sa tapat na patuloy na magliligtas po sa amin. Panginoon, maraming salamat po. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Let us join the worship team as they lead us in worship.
Put our hands together and give Him a clap of praise. We sing Him praises and glorify His name to declare His steadfast love in the morning and His faithfulness by night. Come on! We glorify Your name. Your word is true, it will never fail. Our soul secure that You will carry us through. Seasons will change, the sun and moon will fade away. Our hope is sure that forever You reign. Let it be as You have said. Your ways are higher. You've gone ahead of us. Now we will trust in our unchanging God. Your word unshaken. Your truth will be our light. Now we will trust in our unfailing God. Oh, 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 oh. deserve nothing but praise. You deserve nothing but our whole being, God. Today, we just want to pause for a while and be reminded of how great and good our God is. Open our eyes, God, to see how glorious you are. Help our eyes to see beyond the circumstances, Lord. Open our hearts to give you praise all the time. Our lips will sing you praise all the days of our lives. We magnify your name. May your praises live in every word we speak and with every gift of breath we breathe you in. All the works that you have done consume our hearts. Who in all the earth compares to who you are? Who in all the earth compares to who you are? A thousand hallelujahs, God, will lift unto your name. Lift him up because that's who he is. Mm-hmm. adore you and shout of your fame. So holy, so worthy, so great is your name, that the earth will adore you and shout of your fame. So holy, we will never get tired lifting the name of the Lord high in this place. We'll adore you and shout up your fame. Oh Lord, we bless your name, Jesus. To the one, to the to our King upon the throne, to the Christ, to our Savior, to the risen Son of God, blessing and honor, glory and power. So blessing and honor now and forever. Salvation belongs to our God. Blessing and honor. Blessing and honor. Oh, we sing to our hope. That's it, church. No one like the Lord. So
It says in 1 Chronicles chapter 29 verse 11, "Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty, for all that is in the heavens and in the earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all." You know, church, I believe some of us right now are feeling disappointed in ourselves, events that has happened this 2020. Lord, some of you are even saying, "Lord, what has happened to all the plans, all the things that I wanted to do?" And you feel like everything is on pause. You know, have hope, because the word of the Lord to you right now is, "My name is greater. My name is greater than all the things that you are afraid of." And you feel like, what will come of 2019? Ano na mangyayari next year? 2021? Ano na mangyayari, Lord, next year? And the Lord is saying, "You will be safe with me. Your future is safe with me." And the Lord is even saying, "Declare against those lies and doubts." Just like David did. You come against me with fear, with lies, with worries, but I come against you in the name of the Lord. Have confidence in the name of the Lord, because I am the one who will make things happen. I will be the one who will support you, who will provide for you, because there is nothing you should be afraid of. You feel like, "God, ha, paano na yung school? Mukhang buong year na naman, studying at home. Some of you will be working at home. Some of you are still postponing the things that you want to do." But the Lord is saying, "My name is greater. Lean on me. Trust in me with all your heart, maybe not on your own understanding." Thank you, Lord, for your word.
Amen. How many of you that you need to hear that word about the greatness of God over your lives? Alam po, kaya nga po nung nabanggit po ni David, really, this year, marami tayong mga challenges that somehow it causes a lot of anxiety, maraming mga mental health issue. But I want for us to embrace the truth of who God is. That God is greater than any problems and trials that you might be facing right now. And the only thing that we need to do is to focus on Him and not the circumstances that we are facing right now. That every time that we worship the Lord, pag nakatingin po tayo sa ating Panginoon, yung mga problema po natin lumiliit. Amen? Can we just pray right now and meditate on that message? Lord, again, we just want to praise you and honor you for who you are, Lord, in our lives. That you are our great and awesome God. Panginoon po namin na mas makapangyarihan po kayo, masigit po kayo sa lahat po ng mga problema, mga pagsubok na pinagdaraanan po namin. And we just ask, Father, that every day, Lord, we will be reminded of who you are, Lord, in our lives. That you are faithful, that you are good, and that you are a loving Father who cares for us. Alam niyo po, Panginoon, lahat ng mga pinagdaraanan po namin. And we pray, Father, that every day that you will remind us, Lord, that we will not listen, Lord, kung ano po yung mga sinasabi ng mundo, Panginoon, but we will continue, Lord, to seek you, that we will continue, Lord, to trust you. Because you are faithful, you are good, Lord. And I speak that blessing right now, Lord, sa buhay po ng bawat isa na narito po ngayon. Panginoon, kung ano man po yung mga pinagdaraanan po namin, maraming salamat, Panginoon, na kayo po yung Diyos na aming pong tagapagligtas. Hindi lang po, Panginoon, niligtas po kami sa aming mga kasalanan, Lord, but you are able to save us, Lord, sa lahat po, Panginoon, na mga pinagdaraanan po namin sa buhay po namin. Ama, we pray, Lord, that we will always worship you and praise you, Lord, all the days of our lives, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Okay, maaari na po tayo makaupo. Okay, 2020 was a year unlike any other. Alam naman po natin, marami pong mga nangyari ngayong taong pong ito. And despite the unforeseen challenges and uncertainties we face, God came through for us and showed His amazing grace all throughout the year. We are thankful for all the miracles He has done in and through us and for each of you. For your dedication to reach the campuses, plant churches, and reach the nation for Jesus. Let us watch this video.
When the pandemic struck the Philippines in March, thousands of students were stranded without much necessary supplies. Seeing this challenge, our campus missionaries and leaders looked for ways to meet their needs. We gathered resources and partnered with the schools. Little did we know, our small acts of service would open opportunities we never had before. At the University of the Philippines in Los Baños, our campus ministry volunteered to deliver food to stranded students since many were unwilling to leave because of fear of being infected. Through the partnership with the university, we served and encouraged over 1,000 freshman students in dorms and more than 700 upper-class students outside the campus. Because of this, we were also given the privilege of being the only external organization to assist in holding welcoming events for the freshmen this school year. These efforts led to more students joining our church and small groups online. We were also able to distribute around 800 laptops and give health insurance to deserving senior high school students and college scholars through the Real Life Foundation. Discipleship also continues to grow across our campus ministries. Because of limitations in physical gatherings, we took our youth services and discipleship meetings and outreach events online. When students don't have access to the internet, our campus missionaries reach out to them through other ways, like SMS and phone calls. Campuses are still being reached. In fact, a principal in a school in Santa Cruz, Laguna, now holds victory groups with all 60 of her teachers. Together, we continue to reach the next generation.
We also did not stop declaring and demonstrating the gospel to cities. When our newly planted church in Lemery, Batangas was devastated by the Taal volcano's eruption, Pastor Ferdy Fabul and our leaders didn't allow their circumstances to hinder them from serving and bringing hope to others. They rescued people, visited households, gave relief packs donated by our churches, and ministered to families. Now, our church in Lemery continues to multiply in numbers despite the pandemic because of the strong sense of community. Generosity and service in the church also continue to touch people's lives. We initiated relief efforts across the Philippines called #GoodNews2020 to bless medical workers, policemen, jeepney drivers, impoverished communities, and other people in need. The Every Nation building became a temporary housing facility for frontliners from March to May. And our churches in Lipa and Pasig also opened their buildings for the same use. When typhoons struck our nation, we helped and partnered with the most affected areas through #TyphoonPHRelief. We are grateful to church members who also led and initiated efforts. In Victory Nova, Victory Group leaders volunteered to drive for more than 10 hours to send over 700 relief packs to our church in Cagayan. Our churches in Bulacan also prepared relief packs, and pastors and members drove in trucks and motorcycles to Naga and Cagayan. Leaders in Victory Metro East donated sacks of rice and goods to DSWD as well. And they took the opportunity to pray for the DSWD office and the mayor of Marikina. In the face of a crisis, we continue to pray for our government leaders and find ways to serve our nation.
Church planting also doesn't stop. When the pandemic came, worship services and discipleship never ended. All our churches and pastors were ready to shift activities online. Even with many restrictions, we engage, establish, equip, and empower people. Many are getting saved and baptized even now. In some provinces and congregations in Metro Manila, the number of people in victory groups and discipleship classes doubled. This is unprecedented growth. Despite communication and transportation barriers, the mission continues. By God's grace, we were able to start 4 new churches in Asia, 3 of which were planted by local leaders. Many doors for the gospel also opened, so we now have 14 ongoing church plants across the Philippines. We did not stop meeting together too. Before the year ended, we started to resume on-site services while following health and safety protocols. We are now preparing to open our facilities and worship in all our locations soon. These are all displays of God's amazing grace in our church. No crisis could ever stop His purposes and promises.
Because of God's amazing grace, we got to be the salt and light even in these dark times. Thank you for your faith and generosity in spite of your own personal challenges. As we look forward to 2021, we can be assured that the church can be an unstoppable source of hope to this world because we have an awesome God. Together, in every situation, let's continue to honor God and make disciples.
God, our God deserves our praises. Amen. We can count on the faithfulness of God even at the midst of the difficult circumstances. And even as we face 2021, we can count on and we can continue to trust in the goodness of our awesome God. Because through His faithfulness, we would be able to experience and we'd be able to grow nag-grow tayo sa walk natin sa Kanya. And with that, He deserves all the praises and glory because of the work that He has done in us and through us. So together, let's continue to honor God and make disciples. And as we give, as we worship God through our giving, let me exhort you in this verse found in Philippians chapter 4, verse 17. Let me read this to all of us. It says here, "Not that I seek the gift, but I seek the fruit that increases to your credit." This is Paul encouraging and exhorting the church in Philippi or the Philippian church because of the partnership, because of their generosity. The Philippi church became the partner of Paul when he started his ministry. In fact, it's the only church that partnered with him when he started to share the gospel in Macedonia. But Paul did not seek the gift, as he said. He is actually looking for something greater. And sabi dito, but looking forward to not the generosity, because Paul know that the generosity of the people is just but a fruit. And today, as we give, we are not just trying to achieve yung generosity. Kasi everyone could do that, especially this season. Diba, ilan sa inyo yung mga ninong at ninang? Diba, you're giving gifts to your mga inaanak. I believe it because it's an expectation or probably you're trying to achieve something. But when we give, and especially when we return our tithes and give back our offerings to God, it's not to achieve generosity, but we know that it's just the fruit of a heart that is anchored in God. So when we give today and we offer everything to God, let's continue to trust in Him because with our partnership with God, God is working in us and through us, and the evidence of that is through our works. So as we continue to give our tithes and our offering, let me just remind you that we also want to hear your prayers. So for those people who are online, you could send your prayer requests. There's a QR code that's going to be available on your screens. And also, there's a way for you to give online. You could log into www.victory.org.ph/give, and the detailed instructions to process your giving is there as well. You could return your tithes and give your offering through GCash, through your credit card, or through our PayMaya. And for those people who are on site, you could drop your envelopes at the back of this hall, and you could also drop it to Every Nation and to our facility in Double Dragon as well during weekdays. So together, let's continue to worship God and to honor Him. And as we give today, may I ask everyone to stand up. We'll give our thankfulness, our gratitude, and greatness to God as we sing a worship song. But before that, let's also pray for for our giving. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we honor you today. Thank you for the 2020, God. You've started everything, and I know, God, you are also going to finish it with so much joy, with so much gratitude, and so much greatness because you want to prove to your people that you are faithful. And Lord, as we give and as we offer today, let this be a pleasing aroma as you crown the year with bounty and with the 2021 that's up ahead, Lord. We know that it is you that we can trust and we can always bank on you. So Lord, hear our prayers and hear our praises. We offer it to you. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody says, amen. Let's continue to worship God.
says, Lord, unto me. Ever faithful God, pardon for sin in the peace that endureth thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Lord, unto me. Your faithful God.
Thank you for your faithfulness, God. We praise you. We honor you. I would like for us to turn our Bibles to our passage for this afternoon, 2 Peter chapter 3. We're going to read the last part. If you are watching online and if you can, stand on your feet and respect to the reading of God's Word. Sabay-sabay po natin basahin. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 14, all the way to verse 18. It says here, therefore, beloved, since you are waiting for this, be diligent to be found by Him without spot or blemish and at peace. And count the patience of our Lord as salvation, just as our beloved brother Paul also wrote to you, according to the wisdom given him, as he does in all his letters when he speaks in them of these matters. There are some things in them that are hard to understand, which the ignorant and unstable twist to their own destruction, as they do the other scriptures. You therefore, beloved, knowing this beforehand, take care that you are not carried away with the error of lawless people and lose your own stability. Let's all read verse 18. But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To Him be the glory both now and to the day of eternity. Amen. Lord, we thank you, God, for this day. We thank you for your presence that guided us and sustained us through 2020. And as we look to the coming of a new year, this 2021, we pray, God, that you would give us greater clarity, Lord, to see who you are and to see what you are doing. And may you give us even an open heart and open mind to know you and to experience you even more during this time. Bless the reading and the preaching of your word. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may all take your seats. Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our 2:30 p.m. service. So glad to see all of you who are here on site and those of you who are watching us online. We want to thank you for tuning in. And this is the last Sunday of our 2020. Okay, so who among you here are excited for what's up ahead? Okay, who among you are excited to leave 2020 behind and looking forward to 2021? Okay, so of course, I want to greet everyone a very happy new year to all of you. Those of you who just tuned in, of course, we've been doing this online since we started having the lockdowns. But of course, we're going to continue doing this in the future. Pero ano rin tayo, syempre, as we are going for on-site services. Hopefully, mas lumuwag yung restrictions. And of course, we are looking forward to having as many as possible as the government allows us. All right. So again, happy 2021 to everyone. So glad that you could join us today. And we're starting a new decade. So let's be thankful for God's grace for the 2020. And at the same time, alam ko medyo challenging for us yung 2020 kasi nga ang daming nangyari, ang daming ganap nung 2020. So for many of us, a lot of us are excited to leave 2020 behind. Pero at the same time, we're not sure with what's up ahead in 2021. Of course, meron pang mga scare of COVID mutating and we don't know what's up ahead, yung mga forecast also sa economy natin, we're not really sure. So we're kind of caught in between this tension of wanting to leave 2020, pero at the same time, hesitant to enter 2021. Okay, hindi ko quarantine. Yung iba word of the year is lockdown. Yung iba word of the year is pandemic. Okay, yung iba word of the year, ano ba tayo? Zoom. It's puro Zoom meetings. Mga Zoombies na tayong lahat. Di ba? So we could not encapsulate it with one word. And I'm not sure what your personal word of the year was. Pero yung mga hashtag na naglabasan din, ng mga nagtrending, of course, one of that is yung hashtag stay at home. Okay, so yung iba siguro baka hashtag work from home because this is the year that you really experience the challenge of working from home. Siyempre nga, ang daming nangyari, di ba? Meron Taal eruption, we have COVID-19. Tapos, I don't know if you notice yung typhoon natin, ang dami din. We usually start with A at the start of the year. Umabot tayo ng Rolly, Ulysses, tapos meron pang Vicky. Ewan ko, napansin ninyo na merong typhoon Vicky then that entered our nation. So sana hindi pa madagdagan bago mag-end of the year. But with all of these things going on, it's so hard to summarize what 2020 is all about. And kung hindi natin ma-picture out ano yung word of the year for 2020, na ano kaya yung magiging word natin for 2021? Kung hashtag stay at home, ano kaya yung hashtag for next year? Now, ano kaya yung theme song for 2020? Iba-iba rin yung mga sinasabi ng iba eh. Ang theme song daw ng 2020 is, sa classroom may batas. Kasi bawal lumabas. Bawal lumabas. So hindi ko alam ano yung theme song natin for 2020 and what would be our theme song for 2021. But I would like to encourage us that we don't have to just look to the word of the year. We don't have to just look at what the world says about what 2020 is all about or what 2021 is going to look like. We can choose to look at the word of the Lord. Hindi lang yung word of the world. Kasi yung word of the world, the word of the year, it just defines, summarize what was. Pero ang kagandahan sa word of the Lord, it can redefine how we see the past. It can also guide us and lead us in the present. And it can also help shape and direct our future. That's why it's very important for us to not just look to the news that are always aired around us, we could look to the good news of God's Word. And during this 2020, we've been looking to good leadership. Talagang, if everything rises and falls on leadership, talagang sobrang tested ang leadership natin. Leadership in our marriages, leadership in our homes, leadership in our businesses, leadership in our cities and in our nation. And we look to good leaders, great leaders. Now is the time for great leaders to rise up. But more than looking to these leaders, to these people, and if you're one of those, I feel you, we need to pray that we would rise up to become good leaders. But I think we can look to the good Lord who is our shepherd, who guides us and leads us beside still waters and restores our soul and even prepares a table in the presence of our enemies. And even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we don't have to fear evil. So let's look at the word of the Lord, not just the word of the world. Pagka tinignan natin yung word of God, especially in the passage that we read in 2 Peter, though it was written thousands of years ago, almost 2,000 years ago, the word is very, very timely. In fact, ang kagandahan nga ng letter ni Paul, ni Peter, hindi si Paul, okay? Kasi si Peter is actually considered the apostle of hope. And si John is considered the apostle of love. Si Paul is considered the apostle of grace. Although hindi naman siya exclusive na yun lang yung message nila. Si Peter is more known as being an apostle of hope. Kasi nga he was really highlighting the hope that we have in God. That He is the God of hope, He has the word of hope, and He is our living hope. And ito yung pinaka-message niya to the church that he was writing to. First Peter, he was addressing believers and mostly Gentiles, although he is an apostle to the Jew. He was writing to the believers in general. And this was a time when the believers were actually going through tough times. First Peter is more about the enemy without, yung mga persecution, yung mga trials, yung mga testings, kind of like what we are experiencing right now, although mas matindi yung experience nila noon. The enemy without, kasi nga, noon, pagka Kristiyano ka, you can be persecuted. Wala silang pandemic noon, but it's hard for them to gather together for worship or to know about the word. They don't have the word like we do nowadays. Okay, so iba yung challenges ng faith nila that time. A person can be killed just for being a Christian. In fact, si Peter was killed. He was supposed to be crucified like Jesus, but he said that he wasn't worthy to die like Jesus, so he was crucified upside down. And ang tindi ng pinagdaanan ni Peter, even as a follower of Jesus, and when he was writing 2 Peter as a continuation of 1 one, he was now addressing not just the enemy without, but also the enemy within. He was talking about, of course, like in 1 Peter, ina-emphasize niya yung hope, yung holiness, yung grace ni God. And at the same time, he was encouraging the church to not just be concerned with what's happening all around us, but also be conscious of what is happening within us. Kaya nga pag tinignan natin ng 2020, inap-isip natin, nako, what happened to us 2020? Tapos tinitingnan natin yung 2021, what will happen to us in 2021? With all the worries, with all the concerns, hindi lang COVID, humong here felt na nagkaroon pa ng mga earthquakes recently. Di ba, mga madaling araw. Sino dito napapray kayo bigla, parang, Lord, babalik ka na ba? I've had several of those moments this year. Kami nung asawa ko, may mga kidlat pa lang noon, a few months ago, na sobrang lalaki, tapos sobrang lalapit sa mga buildings. Parang ramdam mo talaga na parang, Lord, is this a sign? Is now the end is near? Di ba, may mga ganun tayong mga moments. And just like what Peter was trying to address in this passage. But I want to remind us, in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 13, when he was talking about the hope, that our living hope is found in God, that Jesus is our living hope, that death could not kill him, therefore our hope should not be killed. Our hope in Christ will continue to rise up against whatever challenge that we will face. And of course, this is what a part of what he was hoping for and looking forward to in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 13. But according to his promise, everybody say his promise, we are waiting for new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. And I'm sure you will agree with me that in this pandemic, in these challenging times, all across the globe, lahat tayo, naramdaman natin yung enemy without, but we also felt the enemy within. Hindi lang yung mga challenges natin na economic crisis, health concern, humong year felt na naglabasan din yung mga racism, naglabasan din yung mga pagiging judgmental, kaya bawal daw maging judgmental. Diba? Naglalabasan yung mga evils also that is in the hearts of men. Na-expose din siya. And when you think of coming towards the end of the world na ba, parang gano'n. Ito yung sinasabi ni Peter, nire-remind niyo tayo, ng hope natin is that we have a living hope, and this is sure, God promised this, that we will have a new heavens and a new earth. So hindi ito yung parang the world is gonna get worse and worse and worse, and then our only hope is that God will take us out of here so that the end can come. No, God also cares for His creation. God also cares for everything that He made that was good and very good. Although the effects of sin ruined all of that, God is going to restore and redeem that, but also that God will deal sin at the root. Kaya hindi lang siya enemy without, it's also about the enemy within. And when that happens, when the end happens, righteousness will dwell in the heavens and the earth, and we will see the fullness of what God promised take place. But let me just point this out to us, that's our hope, a better world. When we are hoping for a better world this 2021, you know, we're hoping for a better future for us and for our children. But I want to remind us that God is not just changing our circumstances, but He is also changing us. Kaya kung yung tanong natin, what happened to us in 2020 and what will happen to us in 2021, part of our response and the perspective that we should have is that what became of us in 2020? And what will become of us sa 2021? Kasi kahit na mag-change yung circumstance, kung hindi naman nag-change yung hearts natin, he'll probably have the same problems next year. I believe God has allowed these things to happen. Although alam ko, marami sa atin, nag-hope tayo, nag-wish na sana natapos na to. Who would have thought December na, no? December, nag-start yung outbreak sa Wuhan. Tapos ngayon, 1 year na, nasa lockdown pa rin tayo, nasa pandemic pa rin tayo. You know, I don't know about you, but I've been thinking and hoping sa talino ng man and the development of science and technology, we could have had an answer by now. But for some reason, we're still not there yet. And that's why I realized that we should stop looking to just simple and temporary solutions, but really look to God, who is the greatest, the wisest, the most powerful being who can actually save us from all our troubles and our concerns. So ngayon, ang tanong is that as God is changing our circumstances, and while we're waiting, while we're still hoping for that to take place, question, nagre-respond ba tayo sa mga changes na ginagawa ni Lord sa atin? And Peter, in this letter, the second letter, is like his farewell letter. Alam niya na he's about to die. He was writing this in Rome, and he was trying to write passionately to the people that he's going to leave behind out of great love, out of great concern. Kaya ito yung sabi niya, therefore, beloved, since you are waiting for this, nire-remind niya of that hope, be diligent. Everybody say, be diligent. Ibig sabihin, be diligent. Do your best. Do everything that you can to be found by Him without spot or blemish and at peace. I think that's one of the things that happened to us this year. Ilan kaya sa atin yung at the start of the year, nung wala pang pandemic, we're so on fire for God, prayer and fasting, talaga dedicated kay Lord. Pero ngayon itong nagka-pandemic, who among here can say na na-challenge pati yung faith ko? Ah. Parang, dati I was really living for God, pero ngayon parang we find ourselves being tempted and being led in a sense to compromising situations. Now, I'm not saying this to condemn us. Remember, this is Peter who was writing this. Peter who denied Jesus 3 times and yet understood the grace of God and the forgiveness of God. I think God is also reminding each and every one of us that we cannot really do this out of our own. We need the grace of God. That's why we have to be diligent. We have to do whatever we can to be found in Him without spot, without blemish, and at peace. Meaning, meron tayong peace with God, and we know that we are right where God wants us to be, where nothing is missing and nothing really is broken regardless of what's happening all around us. Kaya nga gusto ko i-commend yung mga people in our church who this year, kahit nagka-pandemic na rin lang, they still continued with their discipleship classes kahit na online. Nag-continue pa rin ng one-to-one online. Nag-continue pa rin mag-victory group kahit online. Kahit zombies, tulad nakita nyo sa video kanina, kahit text messaging, nag-one-to-one pa rin. Diba? Yung iba, nag-victory weekend online. Yung iba, nag-leadership 113 pa. Because we know that in the midst of our challenges, all the more that we need to be diligent, so that we will not be shaped and conformed by the patterns of this world, but instead more and more conformed into the word of the Lord and aligned with His will and His plans for us, which is always good, pleasing, and perfect. You know, many times, like what happened to the time Peter was addressing the church, yung iba iniisip na, mukhang tagal naman ni Lord bumalik. They gave up on that hope. Wala naman siguro talagang judgment na mangyayari. Yung iba takot sa second coming. Wala naman siguro kasi why would God allow that? Well, Peter was trying to address na, no, there will be judgment that will take place. If God is a good God, He will not allow evil to continue. If God is such a good God and a great God, He cannot just allow evil taking place and harming innocent children or adults or old women or families to be broken, you know, or the world to continue to be broken. He made it good. And He is such a good God, He will not allow that to go on like that forever. Judgment will take place. And for Peter to emphasize this, naglagay pa siya how three events in Scripture. The rebellious angels were judged during the time of Noah. Akala ng mga tao, walang judgment. But the flood came. During the time of Sodom and Gomorrah, akala nila, walang judgment. But judgment came. And now Peter was trying to remind the people, don't think that there will be no judgment. Judgment will take place. That's why we have to respond properly. That's why we have to be diligent. Actually, when Peter was addressing this, he wasn't just talking about the world, but he was talking about even corrupt teachers and religious leaders of the day. And who among you can agree with me na itong taon na to, we've seen also a number of people, popular worship leaders, celebrity pastors and preachers, because of something, like scandal. Now, I'm not saying that to judge them. I'm saying that if these great leaders been used by God mightily to influence others could fall like that. Each and every one of us could fall like that as well. Kaya kailangan yung response natin, Lord, we need to be vigilant. Help us to be vigilant. How can we always stay close to you instead of being far from him? He went on and said, count the patience of our Lord as salvation. Just as our beloved brother Paul also wrote to you according to the wisdom given him. So sinasabi ni Peter na judgment is going to take place, it is sure, but just because God is not bringing the judgment right away, it doesn't mean that God is not faithful in keeping his promises. In fact, Peter was saying, kaya siya being patient, hindi niya fully nire-release yung anger natin. And sometimes we think, okay lang, kahit nagkasala ako, hindi naman ako ginudge ni Lord. So baka tinolerate lang niya. You know, it doesn't mean that it's okay with God. It just means that He wants to give us room to be saved. He is being patient with us, not wanting anyone to perish. Look at this in verse 9. Hindi natin to binasa, but if you go back several verses in the passage that we read, the Lord is not slow to fulfill His promise, as some count slowness, but is patient toward you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should reach repentance. Kaya pala wala pang judgment day, and sometimes we think it's a bad day, judgment day. Well, it's bad if you're bad. It's bad if you know you're going to be judged, but it's good if you know that you're going to be redeemed. It's good news. The judgment will take place, that evil will be forever dealt with. Not just externally, but also internally. Ayaw nyo ba noon? Darating ang time, hindi na tayo magsa-struggle with temptation. We can just fully experience God in the fullness of whatever He would allow us to have. Pero alam din natin at the same time na while we are here, and that's why Peter was talking to the church in general, like the Israelites, we are chosen, we have been elected by God, pero strangers and exiles lang tayo in this world. This is not yet the world that we're supposed to experience for eternity. There's going to be new heavens and a new earth. But while we're waiting for that to happen, hindi ibig sabihin na hindi na faithful si God sa promises niya. In fact, His promises are sure. And Peter highlighted that. We saw this Jesus who rose again from the dead. He fulfilled the promise. And what He said, He will fulfill. Death could not stop Him from fulfilling His promise. Sin and grave and hell cannot stop Him from fulfilling His promise. So yung promise niya in the future, mangyayari talaga yan. But guess what? Habang hindi pa yun nangyayari, may gustong gawin si God. For people to be saved. For people to turn away from their sins and to turn to God. And I believe this is not just a message for those who are not Christians yet. This is also a message for the believers. That all should reach repentance. But itong mga corrupt religious leaders of the day who were into immorality and of course being materialistic and consumed by money and power. It messaged ni Peter na, let's not live this way. Let's turn away from this and turn to God. Let's not align ourselves with the world. Let's align ourselves with the Lord and the word of the Lord. God's timing is different from our timing. But His timing is always perfect. Let's not mistake that God's patience towards us is something that we can just take easily and so that we could play around with sin. Siguro magre-repent na lang ako pagka malapit na bumalik si Lord. You know, that it should not be the attitude, but we should be vigilant. We should be thankful that God is being patient with us. Tulad ng kinanta natin kanina, who among you are glad that His mercies are new every morning? Pero we don't wake up in the morning and say, thank you, Lord, ah, may bago kang mercy. Let me sin some more today. No, that's not the response. The response is, God, thank you, Lord, that I don't have to worry about stumbling and falling, because if I stumble and fall, you're always there to catch me. But I'm not living to fall. I'm not living to stumble. I want to live for you. I want to live to please you, honor you, and help me by your grace to do that. Look at this in verse 17. You therefore, beloved, ito si Peter, no, talagang love na love in church, knowing this beforehand, take care. Can you say that with me? Take care. That you are not carried away with the error of lawless people and lose your own stability. Pakisabihan nga yung katabi mo, una, pakisabihan naman na be diligent. Yung kabilang side mo, pakisabihan, take care. Okay, let's be diligent to stay spotless and without blemish and at peace. On the other hand, that we should also take care that we will not be carried away by the error of lawless people. Yung mga taong ayaw sumunod kay Lord, yung mga ayaw na sumunod sa batas. Okay, yung mga taong unstable, to the point na tayo rin, baka ma-lose natin yung stability natin kay God, yung faith natin kay God. And he was trying to address how during this time, may mga false teachers din na kumakalat that actually swayed people from their faith. And actually, we are hearing also words like that all around us. So minsan, hindi mo na alam. Kasi nga, yung iba masyado nakafocus sa end of the world. 666 na ba? Diba? Ito na ba yung time na Antichrist and all that? So yung iba, sinasabi, ito yung Antichrist. Pero yung mga Christians naman, antay ng antay kay Christ. So minsan, hindi mo na alam kung ano ba talagang gagawin natin. But we have to go to the Word so that we will not be carried away by error. God is faithful to His Word, and we need to grow in understanding the Word so that we will not lose our stability. And I think ditong 2020, a lot of things happened that shook us by surprise. Many of us lost our balance. Many of us lost our bearings. Hindi mo alam, saan ba ako lulugar? Dito ba ako? Where do you want me to go? And a lot of us have probably experienced the many changes that are happening. And it's not yet done. Marami pang possible na mangyari in the future. But as Peter was trying to remind us, we have a living hope, we have a sure hope. When we have our anchor in God, our Lord, our Savior, we will not be carried away. We can stand our ground in the midst of what's happening all around us. At ito, binigyan niya tayo ng advice. In verse 18, we read this a while ago. But grow in the grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. If you want to be diligent, if you want to be taking extra care na hindi tayo masway, paano ba natin gagawin yun? Here's the advice. First advice, grow in the grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Kung yung nangyari sa atin this year, ang daming nangyari, ang daming pandemic and problems and all this external, in a sense, maybe God allowed that so that we could grow internally in the grace of God. That we are undeserving and unworthy of the blessing that God has given us. And yet somehow, si God, He is leaning. That's what grace means. He was leaning towards us to show us benefit, to show us favor, to show us goodness and kindness. Now question, when we are losing our balance, saan ba tayo nagli-lean? Are we leaning towards God, trusting His grace, trusting His blessing, trusting His favor that we don't deserve? Or are we leaning towards our own works, how worthy we are, how deserving we are? Kasi pag yun yung leaning natin, doon tayo bumabagsak, nagagalit tayo kay Lord. Nasisira yung faith natin, Lord, ba't mo inalaw to? Sama mo talaga. Pero pag naintindi mo na, God, I'm so unworthy, I'm so undeserving, as I lose my balance, Lord, help me draw near to you more. Help me rely on you more. I need your grace, God. I need your favor. I need your blessing. And I believe in this church, many of us also received blessing in the midst of this pandemic. somebody got married and at the same time found out they're gonna have a child. A lot of people, may mga plan sila at the start of the year. Gusto nila ikasal this month. Ang daming nag-change. Plan A, naging plan B, naging plan C. Pero finally, nung kinasal sila, parang ang conclusion, grabe Lord, mabait mo talaga. Your timing is perfect. You can orchestrate things that are beyond our control. Kaya nga, instead of trying to control our own world, it's actually yielding ourselves to God and say, God, be the Lord of my life. I have a lot of problems, but God, you are the Savior. You are the Lord. You are the Jesus, the Lord saves. You are the Christ. So first advice for us, para yung chine-change ni Lord sa atin must mag-take place so that we can be diligent, so that we can take care, that we will not be swayed and carried away by error, is to grow in the grace and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Say that with me, grow in the grace and the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Na hindi lang tayo nag-grow in the grace, the favor, leaning towards God, na pag may problema, dapat mas lumapit tayo kay Lord. Pag may temptation, dapat mas lumapit tayo kay Lord. Pag may tampo, dapat mas lumapit tayo kay God. Hindi yung parang lalo tayong lalayo kay Lord. And the question is, this is what happened to us. Ang dami nating natutunan. Who among you learned a lot this year? You learned a new skill, natuto kang mag-internet, natuto kang mag-video, mag-vlog or whatever, natuto kang maging plantito, plantita, natuto kang ang daming extra skills na natutunan. But the question, nag-grow din ba tayo in our knowledge of who God is? Experientially knowing Him. Na God, this year, mas nalaman ko Lord, Ikaw talaga yung master ng buhay ko. Ikaw talaga yung dapat na pinagkakatiwalaan ko. Ikaw talaga yung dapat na sinusunod ko. Dapat guidance mo talaga yung inuuna ko. Mas natutunan ba natin na, God, ang dami ko problema, Lord, pero Ikaw lang talaga yung nakakapag-rescue every time I stumble and fall. Na-experience ba natin that He is who He said He is? You know, I mentioned a while ago how the word of the Lord doesn't just help us redefine our past. It doesn't just guide us and lead us in the present, but it also shapes and prepares us for the future. I don't know if you realize this, though. When we started 2020, wala pang pandemic noon, our leadership team, yung mga bishops council natin, your spiritual fathers in our movement were praying to God, what would be the message for the following year. Actually, mga 2 years ahead tayo, nagpe-pray, nagpa-plan kung ano yung sermon na i-feed sa church. And who among here remember that when we started the year, we started with Amazing Grace. Yun yung theme natin ng fasting. Yun yung first series natin of 2020. And then the plan for the whole year, we had 20 plus weeks of this. We looked at Romans, the gospel explained, so that we can know God more. Good News 2020. And who among here believe that it's not a coincidence that God was speaking to us at the start of the year to teach us, to guide us, to sustain us for 2020. Who among you can agree with me that this year we have seen God's amazing grace? Sabi nga nila, if you are alive ng 2020, consider yourself blessed. Blessed ba tayo? Blessed tayo na kahit ang daming challenges, God gave us His grace, His justifying grace, His enabling grace, His sufficient grace, His abundant grace, His enriching grace, and His inviting grace. Ang dami talaga, grace upon grace we have received from God. Hindi lang tayo kailangan mag-survive, but we could actually even thrive. Kung yung iba, ready nang mag-shirt for January, I survived 2020. Tayo, we can say, by the grace of God, there's still a lot of good things that I can be thankful for this past 12 months. And when I think of how God has been speaking to us and preparing us for 2020, I can't help but be amazed. God, faithful ka pa rin talaga, no? Hindi mo pala kami talaga pinababayaan. Ginaguide at nililid mo pa rin talaga kami. Even before we go through something difficult and something challenging. Tayo lang minsan kasi we have already our own plans for the future. Pero His thoughts are so much higher than our thoughts and His ways are so much higher than our ways. Pero pag natututo tayo to rely on Him, to rely on His wisdom, to rely on His grace, and the more we know Him, the more that we can say, God, buti na lang Ikaw yung God, hindi ako. Buti na lang Ikaw yung nasusunod, hindi ako. Second thing that we can be reminded of so that we can continue to be aware kung paano ba tayo chine-change ni Lord, paano ba tayo tinutulungan ni God to be diligent and to always take care that we will not be swayed away, is the last part of verse 18. It says there, to Him be the glory both now and to the day of eternity. Amen. The second thing that I would like to remind us is that let's be reminded to give God the glory. God is glorious. He is magnificent. He is someone that is unlike any other. That's what holy means. Set apart. He is unlike His creation. And though we can know Him, He is actually beyond comprehension. Though we can talk about Him, He is actually beyond words. And that's why yung glory is just like a word to describe na parang, God, You're weighty. Iba yung bigat ni Lord. Bigatin si God. Okay? And when you think of the glory, the opinion, that's also the word means. Pag tinignan mo yung opinion ni God, God's opinion should weigh more compared to the opinions of the world. Because God created the world by the power of His word. And when God speaks something compared to what the world is saying, we have to take God's word to heart. Dapat yun yung mas mabigat at mas matimbang sa atin. And I hope this 2020, naramdaman natin, ah, grabe, yung mga bagay na mga mabigat sa atin, importante, pwede lang palang mawala. Pero buti na lang kahit nawala lahat to, dahil nandyan si God, we're still okay. And at the end of it all, God's glory will be displayed all the more. Think about this during the Christmas, and we just celebrated Christmas, at the darkest time, at the darkest hour, God was doing something glorious. If you think of the cross, when Jesus was hanging there and dying, people were thinking that was the worst possible time. Why? The leader that they thought would save them, the Christ, the one who heals the sick, the one who feeds the hungry, the one who raises the dead, is actually dying on the cross. But they don't realize that that's actually a glorious time, because God is showing us that even in His weakness, just by giving His life away, He's going to give us victory over sin, victory over hell and grave, victory over death. Kaya nga in our darkest hour, doon mo walang kita na parang, Lord, Your light is shining somewhere. And we may not see it yet, but God, You're doing something powerful. Kahit hindi pa natin nakikita sa news, God is doing something. Kaya in the end of it all, who will be glorified? Ngayon, na-realize natin, teka muna, sino bang mag-glorify natin? Yung good leaders ba natin? Whoever can come up with the smartest solution for this, hopefully makagawa ng maayos talaga na vaccine or may medicine in the future. Pero in the end, who will really give the glory? To whom? I hope tayo, the more we have experienced this 2020 and the more we look forward to 21, I hope we'll realize that in the end, all glory belongs to God alone. He will not give His glory to another. He will not allow someone to touch and get the glory that belongs to Him, because we are not gods. We're not created to be gods. We're not created to be worshipped. And we should not worship false gods. We should not even worship ourselves. But we should worship the one true God who is worthy of all glory, honor, and praise. Now, what's interesting is that at the start of this 2021, yung fasting theme natin for 2021 is Awesome God. Hindi lang yan yung fasting theme natin. That will be our first series for 2021. Kung Amazing Grace ng 2020, Awesome God ng 2021. We're going to look at the different names of God that reveals to us what kind of a God He is, His nature, His character, His will, and His plans, and His intentions. So, actually, kung titingnan mo, Amazing Grace sa 2020, Awesome God ng 2021, pwede mo rin pagbalikta rin yan, okay? Amazing God and Awesome Grace. But here's what's getting me excited. Kung si God nag-speak sa atin ng Amazing Grace ng 2020, and I believe for many of us, we have experienced God's amazing grace throughout 2020. Imagine with me what would happen to us the more we know and understand that God is an awesome God. That He is someone that inspires awe and majesty and worship. And every time God performs miraculous things, ang response ng mga tao, they are in awe. They are bewildered. They were amazed. They were in wonder. They would end up bowing down and worship away from me, Lord, a sinful man. And they would end up worshiping God for who He really is and acknowledging that He is the Christ. He is the Savior of the world. Imagine what God would do in 2021. To show to us and to prove to us that our God is awesome and powerful and majestic and glorious and someone who is worthy of all glory and praise. Kaya hinahope ko as we enter 2021, the more we will realize na hindi 2021 year of the pig or year of whatever animal is out there. It has and will always be the year of the Lord. And we have a great God. We have a good God. His grace is amazing. Praise God for that. But there's so much more about God that we are yet to know. There's so many of His promises that we are yet to experience. There are so many things that God still wants to do, that those who will believe in Him will hear and walk through it and experience that all of His promises are trustworthy and all of His promises and His will and His plans are indeed good, pleasing, and perfect. So I want to invite each and every one of us and the worship team to come up right now. To all stand, let's all stand. And we're going to end by celebrating and praising God for who He is. I would like for you to think back for the past 12 months and think of your own personal headlines. And hindi lang yung personal headlines, but think of God's amazing grace all throughout this year. And as we recount His faithfulness, we're going to worship Him. We're going to declare His praise. And as we do that, I believe God wants to speak His words of assurance, His promises for each and every one of us as we enter the next year. Can we just take this time to just fix our eyes on Him? God, we look to You. We're grateful, God, for Your amazing grace that has sustained us through this year. Lord, maraming nangyari that's beyond our expectation. It's probably not even according to our plans. But Lord, there are also a lot of blessings that we didn't even ask for or prayed for, but You are trying to show us, God, that we can trust You, that You are in control, that Your plans are perfect, that Your will is even good and pleasing. Lord, kung nakonsuman kami, Lord God, with what we have missed, kung ano man yung nagkulang, kung ano man yung nawala, Lord, to the point na hindi na namin na-appreciate yung mga blessings na binibigay mo sa amin, Lord God. Like the life that we have, our health, the family that we have, Lord, and the relationships that we have, or even sometimes the church that we are in, Lord God. Lord, kung ginawa man ng pandemic, Lord God, na palayo man kami sa isa't isa or na palayo man kami sa Iyo, Lord, I pray that God, that You would help us by Your grace to draw nearer to You, to grow in the grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I pray, God, that as we enter 2021, Lord, na hindi lang kami maging conscious sa mga nangyayari around us. But that na maging conscious din kami, Lord, sa ginagawa mo within us. And what You want to do through us. Help us, God, to be diligent, Lord, to stay without spot and without blemish and at peace. Thank You, God, that Your mercies are new every morning, Lord, to forgive us, to cleanse us, to give us a brand new start. But Lord, I pray, God, help us to walk victoriously, God. Hindi tulad ng sinabi sa Peter as well, that though we're forgiven. There are people who, like a dog returns to its vomit or a pig returning to the mud. Lord, I pray that you would help us to walk in purity and holiness, to live our lives fully for you and for you alone. Help us to know you more in such a way, God, na hindi kami easily makikarried away with errors and false teachings. Lord, but we would know you, that the sheep will recognize the voice of the shepherd. Lord, that we can discern your spirit and discern the truth of your word, that we may align ourselves with what you're saying, not just what the world is saying. We declare, God, that you are worthy of all glory, honor, and praise, both now and to the day of eternity. God, that in the end, your glory will be displayed like never before. That people will know, God, that there's the one true God who loves us so much and who cares for us, not just for the church, but even for the rest of the world. I pray, God, that we would truly live lives that glorify you, lives that honor you. That whether we eat or drink, Lord, in everything that we do, it will be for your glory. Na hindi lang kaming Sunday Christian, Lord God, but every day of our lives, for the rest of our lives, God, it will be like a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to you. We worship you with our lips. We worship you with our hearts. We worship you with our whole being. We give you praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name. Come on, let's just praise him. Let's just worship him. Let there be a response to who he is and what he has done.
Search our hearts, O Lord. Would you search our hearts and know our thoughts? See if there's any grievous way in me, there's any distrust, forgive me, Lord. We approach your throne. Pardon for sin and the peace that endures. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. You are faithful, you are faithful. Great is thy faithfulness. Sing it out, he deserves it. Lord, Because you are faithful, Lord, we will give you praise. Help us remember how good you are, God. Help us be reminded every minute of the day how faithful, how steadfast your love is. For we know that we will respond to you the way we know you, Lord. Because you are great, we worship you, we give you praise. Because you are holy, that's who you are. He is great. With your own words, just magnify who he is in your life. You are good, Lord. You are holy. You are worthy. You are holy. So worthy. We lift your name high above. Be enthroned. Be enthroned. Be enthroned in our hearts, Lord. Your majesty, your beauty, we glorify your name.
Reminding us of how faithful you are, Lord, in our lives. Maraming salamat po, Ama, for reminding us that the reason why we can have hope, Lord, for this coming year, not because of our own strength or abilities, Lord, but because you are faithful. You are good. You are strong. You are mighty. Panginoon, sa hapon pong ito, maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa inyo pong katapatan sa bawat isa sa amin. And we just ask, Father, that we will just continue, Lord, to look up to you, Lord. Patuloy po kami magtitiwala sa inyo, Panginoon, dahil kayo po yung tapat ng Diyos na nagmamahal po sa bawat isa sa amin. And I speak that blessing, Lord, to each and every one of us, that we will continue, Lord, to have that hope because you are with us. Maraming salamat po. In Jesus' name. And before we leave, let me read this verse from Romans chapter 15, verse 13. It says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. God bless us everyone and a blessed Happy New Year. Maraming salamat po. You are dismissed. But before you leave, kindly stay at your seat po at tayo po i-guide po ng ushers po natin sa ating pong paglabas dito sa lugar pong ito. Okay, Ljovic.
Yes, Pastor Israel, thank you so much. And thank you once again for those people who stayed online and joined us in our online service. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Yes.
Imaginin mo, Pastor Israel, how many months we've started last March online. And we're ending the year as well, continuing this service online. And it will stay hanggang matapos itong pandemic na to. I'm sure there's gonna be a lot more things that God is in store to each and every one of us.
Yeah. And again, I was blessed sa preaching ngayon, no?
Yes,
being reminded of the faithfulness of God even in the midst of the pandemic. And one thing na natutuhan ko, no, about yung si God is not just only concerned in changing our circumstances, but is also concerned about changing us to those circumstances.
I agree. I couldn't agree more, Pastor Israel. While the world is, you know, by the word of the world, somehow it affects us, it changes the landscape on how we live, but the word of God surely changes us internally. And that's the reason why there's a reason, not to lose hope, because the word that changes us also gives us the ability to show and demonstrate the love of God to people around us. So let's continue to be in the Word and get to know the awesome God that we have.
And at the same time, we can continue to give glory to God even in the midst of this pandemic, kasi alam natin na may ginagawa yung Panginoon sa buhay natin, na may binabago siya.
Awesome God, di ba, Pastor Israel?
Awesome God. That will be our theme next year.
Yes, and talking about that theme, Pastor Israel, we'd like to invite you to join us on our prayer and fasting that's gonna happen on January 11 to 15. Ayan, and of course, excited ka na ba, Pastor Israel?
Yes, of course, pero ang excited muna ako mag-feasting muna before the fasting.
Ayan, so join us, feasting. So please invite me to your house, Pastor Israel.
Kung pwede lang, ano?
Kung pwede lang, Pero 2 weeks after, or a week after that, ayan, we will do our corporate prayer and fasting. So please join us, and of course, invite your family and friends as well to join us as we seek God together. Not that we're not seeking God today, we're always seeking God, but it's just good to do this every start of the year.
And before this year ends, no, of course, yung mga activities natin,
next year.
Baka inaanap nila, bakit walang kids church online, yung bakasyon lang ngayong taon na to.
Yes, though we're not relaxing on the Word of God. Of course, we know that the Word of God still continues to flourish in our houses, in our homes. Meron tayong mga materials actually that's available online sa kids page natin. It's a group. We post it there. Pero Kids Church will resume on January 9 as well.
And even yung mga victory groups, ano? Sabi ko nga doon sa victory group ko, pahinga lang tayo, but it doesn't mean na hindi tayo pwedeng mag-connect during this season.
Okay. Yep, of
sabi ko,
course.
Invite lang kung pwede lang, ano, no, kung available, they can come. Sabi ko sa iba kong victory group na you can come to our house.
Yan.
Not all of them, sabay-sabay.
We need to follow the IATF guidelines as well about, you know, mass gathering and inviting people to our houses. Pero they could also catch yung mga yung youth service natin on January 8 sa Friday youth service natin that's gonna happen as well. They will resume next year in January,
and of course pati yung mga 1 minute ano natin preaching video you can still use that to invite your families and friends na you want them to hear the message of God. Mapapanood pa rin po natin yung mga messages po natin sa YouTube and sa ating Spotify.
Yes, so if you are blessed by the message, why don't you share this and tag along your friends so that they could invite them to our church community. With that said, Pastor Israel,
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! Happy New Year to all of you! And we're signing off this 2020. See you again next year.
See you again next year. Happy New Year! God bless everyone!
Bye!
Bye.
Picture tayo, picture. Year-end picture natin dito sa stage. Oh, last service for this year.
Maraming salamat sa lahat ng mga volunteers. 2020 is done!